Hello, my dear students. I hope you all are keeping well and washing your hands frequently. And I hope you're not troubling your parents and eating healthy food. As you all know, we have to stay indoors and we can't go to school. So today, I, Miss Vanessa, will be teaching you through this video.
Our topic for today is singular and plural, also known as one and many. What is a noun? Nouns are nothing but naming words. Everything around us has a name. So nouns are the names of person, place, animals, and things. A noun that names one person, place, animals, or things is called a singular noun. For example, boy, cat, house, key. A noun that names more than one person, place, animal, or thing is called as a plural noun. Example, boys, cats, houses, keys. Singular means one and plural means many. Time for a story. Observe and listen carefully. Sunny and Minnie decide to go for a picnic. Both of them are very happy and excited. Wow, there are so many things to eat. I can see cake, chip, mango, sandwich, cherry, and cookie. So much yummy food. There's a lot of food for sure. But you are speaking as if there's only one of each item. What do you mean? What are these, Sunny? Well, it's cake. And how many can you see? I can see 6 cake. What about these? Sandwich. No, Sunny, you are using singular noun for all the food items instead of plural noun. What do you mean? When there is only one of something, we use singular naming words. If there was only one of these, we could say one cake, because cake is a singular word. But we have more than one cake, right? When we have more than one of something, we use plural naming words. So we say 6 cakes. Similarly, we have more than one chip, right? So we say chips and not chip, because chips is the plural form. A naming word that is more than one is made plural by adding s. Now, Minnie, pass me the tiffin. We will eat the cakes and have some food. Did I say it right? Yes, you did. Let's dig in. In this picture, there is one bird, one apple, and one girl. Whereas in this picture, there are 3 birds, 4 apples, and 2 girls. So this is called as plural noun. One and many. Girl, girls. Bird, birds. Apple, apples. We add s to make plural naming words, as we saw in the story. Let's add s and see how singular words turn into plural words. P-E-N, pen. P-E-N-S, pens. One pen, many pens. C-A-T, cat, one cat. C-A-T-S, many cats. D-O-G, dog, one dog. D-O-G-S, many dogs. T-R-E-E, one tree. T-R-E-E-S, many trees. B-O-A-T, boat. B-O-A-T-S, boats. One boat, many boats. R-A-B-B-I-T, rabbit. R-A-B-B-I-T-S, rabbits. One rabbit, many rabbits. One pumpkin, many pumpkins. One cat, many cats. One turtle, many turtles. Now, if a singular word ends with O, double S, CH, X, or SH, we add ES to the plural. All the plural words don't end with S. Some of these plural words end with ES. Let's see. Cargo, C-A-R-G-O. As you can see, there is O at the end. So cargo will become cargoes, C-A-R-G-O-E-S. Mango, M-A-N-G-O. Mangoes, M-A-N-G-O-E-S. Echo, echoes. Torpedo, torpedoes. Flamingo, flamingos. Mango, mangoes. Flamingo, flamingos. Echo, echoes. Cargo, cargoes. Tomato, tomatoes. Torpedo, torpedoes. As mentioned before, even if X comes at the end of a singular noun, it will be ES in its plural form. So fox will become foxes. One fox, many foxes. One brush, many brushes. One glass, many glasses. Gas, gases. Bench, benches. Dress, dresses. Box, boxes. Ostrich, ostriches. Bunch, bunches. Loss, losses. Bus, buses. Wish, wishes. Piano, pianos. Princess, princesses. This was all for today's lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you. Bye-bye.